approach as a European to this? What is your understanding of forest and deforestation? Also, given the fact that you've been traveling around the world and your experience, different stories.
Okay. First of all, Pietro, thank you very much for offering me the possibility to talk, to be in this nice event. We are in Europe. We are in the middle between the tropics, South America and Asia. In Europe, we don't have deforestation. If we are talking about numbers, since 1990 to 2014, the forest cover in Europe increased, basically roughly for an area such as the Greece. Nevertheless, we are responsible every year of the deforestation occurring in these two continents for a size basically around the Portugal, 11, 10 million hectares annually. Why? Because basically we are not producing anything. We rely on Europe depends heavily on the agricultural imports. We have to think that roughly one-fifth of the crops and three-quarters of meat and dairy products are imported every year. And so this means that every EU citizen is basically responsible for the import of 1 ton of CO2 annually. Just to have another comparison in terms of deforestation, a French study, pointed out that every citizen, French citizen, is responsible of the deforestation of about 300 square meters per year because he's using products which are imported from South America and from Asia. So this is a very important point. I mean, we are at the end of the 2019, just to face this problem, there was the Green Deal, which has this the very package of policy, very ambitious. We want to make Europe carbon neutral within 2050. And then beginning of this year, I think in May, there was this the European Commission presented some actions to protect and restore the world forest that were based on five main actions. First of all, to reduce the consumption and the footprint of product imported from other places, so to reduce the deforestation. Secondly, to work in partnership with the producing country to reduce the pressure on the forest and so reduce deforestation. To strengthen the international cooperation to help deforestation is also one of these actions. To redirect the finance to support more sustainable land use practices as well. And finally, the fifth action was to support the availability and quality of and the access of information of forest commodity and supply chain, supporting research and innovation. So if you are looking about emission removal after the Paris Agreement at national level, we are obliged to report the emission within each country. So we don't have to take into consideration the emission that we caused in the other countries. And so in Europe, forest is increasing, production is decreasing, so we are increasing our carbon stock. But nevertheless, we are responsible for the increasing of emission elsewhere. So we should encourage the European to eat less meat, dairy product as well. Or otherwise, we need to start producing in Europe. So increase the agricultural land in Europe. I mean, forest is increasing because agriculture was decreasing, because forest is exactly growing on those land that were used for agricultural purposes. So we should convert this land and start to produce again within Europe. But this is, it's tricky because then we will lose our carbon stock, we will increase our emission, and we will increase pollution too. So it's very a tricky point. For this, it's an important moment because, the new CAP is... it's coming. Next year it should be out. The forestry, the forest regulation is supposed to be out at the beginning of the next year. Currently, there is this consultation that will end up the 10th of December involving different stakeholders that can express their opinion about the new forestry regulation. But so there are many things that are going on. But I mean, the Green Deal could offshore environmental damage to other nations. So we need to be very aware of this and be aware of the different aspects involved in this ambitious plan of the European Union. So as Javier was also saying, it could be very tricky if then if instead of moving to Europe, all this production would move in another place, because this doesn't mean to stop deforestation, simply moving the product is the same that, as I was saying, we don't have deforestation in Europe, but we are causing a lot of deforestation at global level.